Hi kids, Grandpa here. Today I've got a bit of a project. I need to change some tires on my pickup truck, and I have a tire changer, and it really works pretty well, but not so well on the big heavy truck tires. In fact, when I changed one of the tires here a few days ago, it bent it a little bit. So I need to make it stronger so that it can do the work that I need to have it do.
This is a tire changing machine. It holds the tire from very tightly underneath by grabbing on to the bottom part of the rim.
The rim is this metal part here. The tire is this part here.
With the rim held very tightly by the machine, the tire can be taken off or put back on.
There's so much pressure going on these outside pieces that they bend.
The other part of the problem is that this special tire iron that helps you take the tire off and put the tire back on the rim is only about 2 feet long.
First thing we need to do is take this thing apart. Now we can take this up to the shop and start working on it.
Hi, Callie. I'm gonna go fix the tire changer. We'll see you later, okay? For one of the handles, we'll make it 3 feet long. Can you see how to read that on the tape measure? 35, 36, 37, and then at 36 is 3 feet. We're going to mark that with a piece of soapstone. Soapstone is really good for marking on metal that you're gonna be heating or burning because it doesn't disappear like a pencil mark.
Okay, I've got my eye protection on, and I probably ought to wear gloves for this job too. So we've got that. Let's go ahead and cut some metal. We are going to cut this too, right there. So let's cut that next. When you weld, it's not a good idea to weld to paint. So that's why we ground this all off right here, so that there's bare metal that we can weld to. We want to make a notch right here so that this pipe can slide all the way down into here. Remember, Grandpa, always wear the eye protection, right? And the gloves. There we go. Now that goes right in.
I want both pieces to have the same amount of leverage. So we'll come down here to the other end and mark it at the same point. Now what's this called that I'm going to mark it with? That's right, soapstone. It's actually a kind of a rock.
Now this one goes in pretty easily. We can just weld it right there. I also cut a little hole right here in the pipe. That way when I weld, I can weld in that spot and that'll give it more strength. I also did the same thing right there. That way we can not only weld here, but we can weld in there. And then we'll fill this hole up with welding material.
We're going to mark this with some soapstone right there. We want to have enough length to start out down here and come up, and then we're going to bend it right there. So we want some extra to be able to do that. We're going to do the same thing for this end.
So now let's cut this. Oh, eye protection, gloves.
Well, there's one of the reasons why we want to wear eye protection all the time. See how that disc, that cut-off disc, is torn to pieces? When it got really small, I caught it on the edge of the metal, and it kind of just disintegrated, and pieces went flying everywhere. But I was wearing safety glasses and gloves, so no problem.
Why do you think I want the plug for this tool where I can see it? We'll answer that question in a minute. First, I'm going to take this blade off, this cutoff blade off, so we can get going again. We have the new cutoff disc back on. So why do we want to make sure we know where the end of the plug is? Yeah, because if I see the end of the plug, then I know it's not plugged in, because I'd sure hate for this tool to come on while my hands are around it. We've got some good things done so far. Shall we take a break and go see what the animals are up to? Yeah, let's go. Well, everybody looks like they're doing okay. Now there's a big nose.
Whose nose do you think that is? Stand back and take a look. Oh, that's Ariel. She's one of the cows.
I've got to go do some things with grandmother, so we'll come back and work on this some more later, okay? We'll see ya. Bye.